And joining us to help us make sense of what's going on within the Defense Department is former Senator and former Armed Forces Chief of Staff, General Rodolfo Biazon. General Biazon, good morning. Welcome to the program. General, I think you're still on mute. We're trying to fix the audio of General Rodolfo Biazon as we're trying to get his statements, his remarks, his comments on what's going on in the Defense Department and Armed Forces. Good morning, General Biazon.
Hi, good morning, Mike. Good morning, Nikki, and everyone.
All right, General, thank you so much for your time with us this morning. But General, what's happening? The shakeup of the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the Department of National Defense, that fueled coup rumors over the weekend. So as far as you know, is there a coup brewing?
This situation requires a lot of clear answers, you know, or it will help to continue the chaos or confusion, you know. This is the first time that this thing has happened to these armed forces of the Philippines and to the country, where you remove one chief of staff, set him to floating, and then replace him with another, and then eventually you remove again this one, and then get back or assign back the one that you relieve in the first place. So this is the first time that this happens. But I would like to assuage the fears of some people about the possibility of a destabilization. I don't think destabilization in the level of what happened to President Cory Aquino or President Arap or President Arroyo can happen. Because number one, there is no rallying issue that can be used as it was before, number one. But the most important thing is there is no more the brand of thinking of some soldiers before. Wala na ngayon yan eh. And I think the present crop of officers and men of the armed forces abide by what they have sworn to, yung kanilang duty. So hindi mangyayari yung nangyayari nung kay President Cory, President Arap, President Arroyo eventually. But this thing is therefore raising a question, so many questions. Number one, is Baccaro covered by the new Republic Act, Republic Act 11706, you know, where it is giving a fixed term for officers in the armed forces, starting from the chief of staff plus seven other officers? Are they covered? Was Baccaro covered? So the problem is, if he was covered, there must be given a reason why he was removed, meaning General Baccaro. In the first place, there was not enough explanation on the removal of General Centino.
There was no explanation at all.
Yeah, General Baccaro is supposed to be to have been retirable in September last year. You know, and General Centino is going to retire or is retirable mandatorily under the old law in for February yet. One and more. So what are the reasons for this rigodon? This is the first time that this thing has happened, as I said, no? You remove one chief of staff without plausible reasons being given, replace it with another, and then you remove this another, and then restore the other one. So this is a very confusing issue. And as I said, it's raising a lot of questions.
General,
one question is, when is the new law? When is the new law effective? 11706. that provides for
General 11709, RA
11709. Yes. So that provides for a fixed term. Of course, under the practices and other certain laws, the president, as the the appointing authority, retains the so-called hire and fire power. And I don't think that has been changed yet, the hire and fire power of the president. We had a, when we were, when I proposed, when I was still in the Senate, proposed the fixed term, a fixed term law. I asked for a definition of the hire and power, the hire and fire and power president of the president. Of course, Senator Joker Arroyo, rest his soul, you know, may he rest in peace, stated that it is very, very difficult to define the limitations of the hire and fire power of the president. Kaya nadyan pa yan, it is retained, you know. And so therefore, we have to hear good and plausible reasons, the removal of Centino, and then the removal of Bacaro, and then explain also why it is Centino who is replacing Bacaro. Now the question is, if I think Centino is already covered by the new law, you know, although he's retiring next month, according to the law, he is fixed term of 3 years, meaning last Saturday should be the reckoning date when you count the 3 years, according to the law.
Not the first time he was appointed as general. So the three-year period for his appointment as AFP chief of staff is not counted as the first time he was appointed?
Then there is another question. Centino, General Centino, had been given an appointment as ambassador to India. And insofar as the commission appointment is concerned, dalawa ang appointment ni Centino. One, ambassador to India, and second, as chief of staff of the armed forces of the Philippines. So, kung ako ang commission appointment, I will be confused. As it is now a fact that many people are confused. For example, there is a concern in the Philippine National Police about a supposed memorandum getting the certain units of the PNP on red alert because of this issue. Eh ngayon, iniimbestigahan niya tayan. Ano? So, meaning, if some government agencies are confused, paano tayo? But there's a question. There's a question.
Certainly, baka, lots of questions.
Baka itong confusion na ito will result in chaos. And we cannot confuse the armed forces of the Philippines. Halimbawa, yan, ngayon, nag-resign si Secretary of Defense. Nilagay si General Galvez. I have no issue about that. The only issue is, what was the reason of General Faustino in resigning? What was the reason? Because things must be clear to the soldiers down there on the ground. Bakit nag-resign ito? May dahilan. Ano yung dahilan na yan? So there is a lot of questions to be asked and to be answered.
General,
is kailan ba effective talaga yung bagong batas, yung 11709? Kailan ba effective yan? Kasi kung effective na yan, and the report is that General Baccaro would be the first chief of staff covered by that law, meaning may additional 3 years siya under that law. Ngayon, nirelieve mo. Kailangan maliwanag ang dahilan bakit mo nirelieve.
Mm-hmm. General, one of the reasons that has been floated why this was what happened is because supposedly there's no implementing rules and regulations yet of RA 11709. Is that sufficient reason for not following the fixed 3-year term?
Okay, but the question is, the law is supposed to be effective 16 days after its enactment.
Mm-hmm.
So now, what is the reason kung bakit wala pa yung IRR?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody somewhere committed a lapse of judgment.
Mm-hmm. General, how do you think this will affect the entire AFP structure? You did allude to it earlier, but you have a very hierarchical system in the armed forces of the Philippines. So what happens to the morale of the men under, at least the officers immediately who were expecting to succeed General Baccaro, but they now had to wait because you have General Centino back and it's not clear if he's going to serve the full 3-year term.
That is the reason why I insist and I say that there must be plausible, clear reasons why these things are happening. Remember, I said, this is the first time that this thing happened to the armed forces of the Philippines. There was an incident before that a chief of staff was relieved before his retirement, mandatory retirement. Isa lang yan, ano? And pero ito, ibang klase ito eh. Kasi tinanggal mo yung isa, binalik mo yung isa, ngayon tinanggal mo na naman yung isa, ibinalik mo yung isa.
Mm-hmm.
So, this is a lot of confusion. And there must be plausible, clear and plausible reasons why these things are happening. And we need to hear from the appointing authority.
General, I just want to go into the relationship between USEC Jose Faustino, General Faustino, and General Centino. They were supposed to be classmates, right? So, but General Faustino was absent during the resumption of General Centino to the top post of the AFP.
Exactly.
And then later on, it appears that he has resigned and the president has accepted his resignation. Are you aware of any conflict between the two?
What was that again?
Are you aware of any conflict between General Centino and General Faustino?
No. And I assume there is none. Because a statement from a functionary in Malacañang says that the relief of Centino was a mistake. So the question is, paano nangyari ito? Is this some lapse of judgment? But the only problem is that if there is this lapse of judgment, it must be clarified. So ang question, saan ba nanggaling itong balita na ito? Ngayon tinatanggi na ng PNP na mayroong memorandum setting some units of the PNP on red alert because of the possibility of a destabilization move. Totoo ba ito o totoo?
Mm-hmm.
So that, a lot of questions must have to be answered. And the answers must clarify the situation. Kasi what we cannot have is a confused armed forces of the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. General, you mentioned that the appointment was supposedly of the relief of General Centino was supposedly a mistake. There are talks that reinstalling him as AFP Chief of Staff was supposedly to correct the error, or at least correct what happened to him. But of course, there are talks that this has something to do with the former executive secretary, Vic Rodriguez, who supposedly was instrumental in appointing Lieutenant General Baccaro to the post. Yes. So if this is true, are we seeing the politicization of the armed forces of the Philippines if the appointments are based on who is the sitting executive secretary or who are the officials in Malacanang, and they can just tinker with the appointments in the armed forces of the Philippines?
Okay, let's go back to a basic and fundamental practice or legal provision. You know? Mm-hmm. The definition of the higher and fire power of the president. Mm-hmm. This is, I think, the one that is being invoked on this situation. But you cannot just do what has been done without creating confusion. Mm-hmm. And the worst agency to be confused is the man with the gun. Mm-hmm. The man with the gun. Kailangan maliwanag lahat sa kanila. Of course, there is a fundamental a principle of the belief and probably culture, if I may say so, no, of the armed forces of the Philippines and the police, that the commander-in-chief is the one that determines everything. Mm-hmm. Commander-in-chief. But there is the question, paano nangyari ito?
And
kasi
he was absent.
Mas maganda pa siguro kung, alam mo, kung mas maganda pa siguro mangyari, this situation will not be as confused as this, it is today, you know. If, kung ayaw ni Presidente o appointing authority kay Baccaro, hindi dapat ibinalik si Santino. Mm-hmm. Pumili na lang ng iba. Mm-hmm. Kasi ito, paano mo explain niya, tinanggal mo, pinalitan mo, yung nagpumalit, pitinanggal mo, ibinalit mo yung tinanggal mo muna. Mm-hmm. This is the one that is creating the question, the situation, or the chaos. Hindi, walang dapat na i-explain except the removal of Baccaro. Mm-hmm. Yes, the president has the power to hire and fire. But because of the importance of the positions, there must be plausible reasons why you are removing the leader of that agency.
Mm-hmm. In the absence, General, of any explanation, there have been talks about the possible reason for the removal of Lieutenant General Baccaro. And they're citing the rift between supposedly the former ES Vic Rodriguez and the First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos. Supposedly, this is a purging of the appointments done under ES Rodriguez. And it's not just happening in the DND and the AFP, but it's also happening in other agencies. So from your point of view, how is the First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos involved in this issue? Because she had to put out a video statement saying she does not interfere in the appointments. But if she finds out that someone is using her name, she will tell her husband not to appoint that person. So why did she have to make that particular video statement? What does that tell you, General?
If it has something to do with the personalities, no, mm-hmm. causing this confusion, I am not aware mm-hmm. of the personal reasons. And mm-hmm. I would like to venture into that. Let it be. If they want to explain it, they explain it. But I'm not going to pursue the question on
I
the
understand.
Issue.
No, I understand.
But ito ngayon. Mm-hmm. Sabi ko nga, the armed forces of the Philippines, the Philippine National Police, must not be put in confusing situation because that's dangerous. You know, mm-hmm. kung confused yung may hawak ng baril, may problema tayo. So, mm-hmm. All of this thing must be clarified. The question is, ito pang news na ito, kung totoo na wala naman yung memorandum ng PNP, putting certain PNP units under red alert because of the situation, ano ba yun? Wala daw eh. Pero bakit lumabas yung balita? So ang tanong ganito, itong mga nangyayaring ito, which are producing confusion, not only with the soldiers and policemen, but mas lalo na tayo, no? Nakukumpiyos tayo. Is this speculative fake news? Fake news ba ito? Na, kung fake news ito, sino naglabas ito at for what reason? Dapat malaman natin yun. Now, however, the worst thing that should be erased is there a politicization of the military? May politicization ba sa military? Again, I would like to believe that wala. All of this is as a result of lapse of judgments.
By whom?
Answer the question. I think you kasi my answer will also be speculative.
Mm-hmm.
And the dangerous thing about speculation is it can be used by anyone.
Yes, but General,
or against the government.
All right, but it's the president who clearly has the appointing authority here. Shouldn't he be the one making the explanation? And what does his absence last Saturday tell you?
Kaya nga eh. Halimbawa, first time na, I would say, in a major turnover ceremony, the top gun of the agency should have been there.
Mm-hmm.
Bakit wala siya dun? What is the reason? And why was this turnover held in almost in secret?
Mm-hmm.
Bakit? Kasi it is normally during turnovers na ganyan, madidinig natin ano ba ang proposal ng bagong leader ng agency. Mm-hmm. He will have to spell it out. Like when I retired as chief of staff in 1991, ang tanong ko eh, co-bodies soldiers, where are we going?
Mm-hmm.
Because of the confusion of the time. Although the confusion of the time is not the same as the confusion today.
Mm-hmm.
Luckily for us, I think the armed forces of the Philippines is so professionalized that it does not matter sino ang nasa taas.
Mm-hmm.
Provided that yung nasa taas, hindi kinukonfuse yung nasa ibaba.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say, ito, na the confusion of the Cory regime, the Arab regime, the Arroyo regime, insofar as the armed forces stabilization functions in society is concerned, wala ngayon yan.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Wala ngayon.
Is this somehow related to the PNP courtesy resignation issue? Because that has also created some confusion among the PNP, among the police.
That's another matter, ano, that must be clarified. Why do you ask the whole command to submit courtesy resignation? Why? There are procedures. There are agencies that addresses the question of corruption or malfeasance, misfeasance in the organization. Merong ano yan eh. Merong mga organization yan. So why do you replace that with asking the whole command to submit resignation? You put everyone in doubt. Pagka ganun. So that's another issue, that's a separate issue anyway, that should be clarified.
General,
mass resignation.
As a final note, how do you think all of these confusion, whether in the PNP or the AFP or the DND, how do you think these should be resolved?
a simple explanation and a simple adherence to legal processes.
Mm-hmm.
Legal processes. Kaya nga, eh, na-confuse tayo eh. Tinanggal si General Centeno. Pinalutang-lutang. Ano? He was put in floating status. Inilagay mo si General Bacaro. After a while, without a simple explanation, except the explanation of Executive Secretary Rodriguez,
mm-hmm.
na, so ano ngayon, pinaglalaruan ba natin ang Armed Forces of the Philippines? Which is causing the confusion. There must be a plausible and credible explanation to these events, to these happenings, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
We need to hear the explanation mm-hmm. and give them the chance to explain this.
Mm-hmm. And General, just one more question, because this is an issue with the PNP, that there are supposedly some generals involved in the illegal drug trade. Are there also members of the AFP, whether officers or personnel, involved in the illegal drug trade, as far as you know?
Wala na eh. Kasi the last, although meron pa na graduate sa from the military who joined the PNP. Ano, meron pa yan eh. Dati, ang PNP was under, or Constabulary was under the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Ano? Mm-hmm. Eh ngayon, hindi na ganun eh. Since 1991, wala nang graduate sa PMA na na-assign sa PNP.
Mm-hmm.
Pinigil na ito.
I'm actually asking general involvement in the illegal drug trade. Are there members of the Armed Forces of the Philippines who are supposedly involved in illegal drug trade? Drugs.
Well, again, as I said, since nag-separate ang PNP from the Armed Forces, the PNP has become a civilian agency. And they are not anymore covered by the so-called Articles of War.
Mm-hmm.
So it is the civilian authority that is, especially Secretary of Interior and Local Government, mm-hmm. ang kanilang boss. Hindi na si Secretary ng DND. Hindi na.
Mm-hmm.
So iba nang they are operating in terms of standards, ano?
Mm-hmm.
Even legal standards, the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the Philippine National Police are two distinct agencies covered by different legal standards.
Mm-hmm. That we understand, General.
Magkaiba.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for your time with us this morning. We certainly got a lot of insights from you, from a former chief of staff yourself and a former lawmaker. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, General Rodolfo Biazon.
Thank you.